Hello friends, welcome to Programming Concepts. My name is Amit and this is part 4 of ASP.NET Core MVC tutorial. In this video, we will talk about ASP.NET Core project file and its usage. This is continuation to part 3, setting up IDE for ASP.NET Core development. So please watch it before proceeding to this one. I shared the link in the description. And here is the project which we are working with. So in the Solution Explorer, you can see there is appsetting.json, program.cs, startup.cs, but not the project file. So to open the project file, right-click on project, open folder in File Explorer, and here it is. Here, first name, which is equal to my project name, which is ProConcept, .cs. CS here stands for C#. In case of F#, that would be FS. And next is proj. Proj stand for project. So CS project. Let's see how we can open this in Visual Studio. So right click on project and click on edit project file. Here it is. You can see there are very limited number of lines available here. We'll talk about them in just a bit. But before that, let's see how the project file looks in previous versions of .NET framework. To compare the project file of previous non-.NET Core web application, I created a web application project in Visual Studio 2015. And here it is. Right-click on the project in Solution Explorer. And here you can see there is no option available to open project file. And to open that, we first need to unload the project. This is the first difference. Let's unload the project. And now you can see edit project file option. Click on it. And here you can see most of the configurations are managed through .cs proj file. So here, which platform we are using, it's specified there. Whether to use IIS Express or not, it's there. And what are the different reference included in our project is also managed via .cs proj files. Let's close that file and reload the project. And let's get back to .NET Core web application. Another difference is, whatever files present within the project directory is a part of that project itself. Let's see what does that mean. So right click on project, open folder in File Explorer. And if I create any new file here, right click, create new text file. So on the right hand side, you can see the reference is already included in Solution Explorer. So that simply means that particular file now is a part of that particular project. Let's see what's the behavior in previous versions of .NET framework. Let me move to Visual Studio 2015. Right click on project, open folder in File Explorer. And if I create any new text document here, click enter. So on the right hand side, you can see that reference is not been included. So click on show all files. Here you can see it is there, but it is not included as a part of this project. So if I have to include this, I need to right click on that particular file and include that in project. Let's confirm whether that particular file is included in the project or not. So for that, we need to unload the project first. So right click on the project, click on unload project, right click and open the CS proj file. And if you scroll down within the item group, you can see that content include new text document.txt. So this is another difference. Previously, everything, every reference has been covered via .cs proj file, but that's not the case now. Let's get back to .NET Core application. This proj file is an XML based format. So the first line specify the root node of .NET Core project using microsoft.net.sdk.web. Next is target framework within property group tab. And to define a target framework here, we use something called target framework moniker. So let me take you to the Microsoft website where they define what target framework Moniker is all about. So according to Microsoft, when you target a framework in an app or library, you are specifying the set of APIs that you would like to make available to the app or library. You specify the target framework in a project file using a target framework moniker, in short, TFM. Below you can see there are different frameworks available with their TFMs. So if you want to use .NET 5, our latest stable version is 5.2, so you need to specify .NET 5.2, which we already specify in our project. If you want to use .NET Core 3.1, then you need to specify .NET Core App 3.1, which is its target framework moniker. If you want to use .NET Framework 4.8, then you need to specify .NET 48. And below is the whole list of target framework with their TFMs. Next, let's get back to .NET Core application and let's try to add any package via Nuget Package Manager. And to do this, let's click on Tools, Nuget Package Manager, Manage Nuget Packages for Solution. Within the Browse tab, let's find out JSON. So newtonsoft.json, let's click on it and let's install that particular Nuget package within our project. Let's click on install and the installation begins. It will take some time. Let's click on output to check whether yes, it's completed. So let's get back to .cs proj file. So you can see the reference has been added within item group. Newtonsoft.json version this much. Click on the solution explorer. Click on dependency packages. You can see that reference has been added there as well. So when we delete that reference, so that reference will be automatically removed from .cs proj file as well. One more thing which we need to consider is addition of new folder. So for that, right click on the project, click on add new folder. So the reference of folder also added in .cs proj file. So when I delete that folder from Solution Explorer, reference will automatically delete it from .cs proj file. Here it is. So let's wrap up this video. So the chproj file includes settings related to target.NET Core framework, NuGet packages, references, folders, etc. So that's it from this tutorial. Thanks for watching.